In the past few videos, ChargerLAB took apart several Thunderbolt 4 cables, and today we got another Thunderbolt 4 cable from Zikko, a Hong Kong brand. This cable was launched last year and is 0.8 meters. Let's take it apart and see the internal design. The front of the packaging is printed with Zikko and Thunderbolt logos, and it can support 100 watts charging and 8K video. Flip to the back, we can see a comparison chart between Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 4 cables. You can pause to take a look. Open the box, it's just in a plastic bag. It adopts the traditional black. Let's take a closer look at the full pin design. Here are the Zikko and Thunderbolt logos, which can tell it apart from other cables. The protective sleeve between the cable and the connector can make it more durable, and is marked with 100 watts. The outer layer adopts the most common TPE, pretty smooth. The length is about 0.8 meters, the diameter is 4.45 millimeter, and weight is about 36.6 grams. The ChargerLAB Power ZKM00-C shows it can support 20 volts, 5 amp, 100 watts, and 40 gigabits per second. The disk speed test shows the speed can reach the Thunderbolt 4 standard, and charging power can also reach almost 100 watts. This time, we added the voltage drop test, which is important in judging the cable quality. In daily charging, the voltage and current are from one side to the other side of the cable, so we can know the voltage loss through the cable due to impedance. Connect both connectors of the cable to the tester and the load, and calculate the difference between the input and output voltage. Here are the results of the voltage drop test. We can see that the voltage drop value increases as the current increases. So the highest voltage drop is 0.543 volts at 20 volts 5 amp. The data shows that its quality is quite good. After the brief introduction, let's take it apart. Firstly, let's cut it off. There are 16 wires inside, those 8 thicker ones are coaxial cables. After that, the wires are wrapped with another black insulating tape. Finally, we can see those 16 wires in different colors, which are used for data transmission and power supply separately. Let's separate and introduce them one by one. The thick red wires are used for positive power supply, and the USB 2.0 wire is green. There are 8 thick coaxial cables inside, which are white, orange, red, black, gold, green, blue, and brown respectively. They adopt the same design. And the first layer is a plastic insulating layer, and the silver-plated pure copper shielding layer is under it. The most internal wires are also plated with silver and wrapped with transparent shielding layer. The silver-plated wires can reduce cable loss. And then the yellow one is VCON wire, the blue one is CC wire, and the black one is SBU wire. Finally, a thin orange wire. Then let's use the cutting machine to remove the plastic cover on the connector. After removing the cover, the PCB is protected by brass sleeve, and there are 12 solder joints on each side, which can fix the connector and the junction. And after removing the brass sleeve, we can see the junction is reinforced by glue. As we mentioned, 2 red wires in the middle are used for positive power supply, and there is no e-marker chip. The USB 2.0 wire and coaxial cable are on the back. Then let's take apart the other connector. The EMARC chip is on the PCB and covered with glue. The information on the chip was erased while cleaning the glue, so we don't know its specific model. And then let's take a closer look at the inside of the connector. Since there is only one pair of D plus and D minus, it only has 24 pins, not 22. You can pause to see what they correspond to. You can also check what their functions are. After completely taking apart, we found it doesn't adopt full pin design, but it won't affect his performance. Those 8 coaxial cables with multiple insulation layers can ensure the transmission stability of the cable. There is only one EMARC chip inside the cable. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to view other teardown videos of Thunderbolt 4 cable. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video.